The subject of physics of atom and atomic nucleus. Lecture number 14, theme alpha decay. At present, more than 200 alpha active nuclei are known, mainly heavy nuclei with A greater than 200 and Z greater than 82. Only a small group of alpha active nuclei occurs in the region with A from 140 to 160, rare S. Alpha decay obeys the rule of displacement. An example of alpha decay is the decay of the uranium isotope 238 uranium with the formation of thorium. Next reaction. The velocities of the particles emitted during the decay of alpha particles are very large and fluctuate for different nuclei in the range from 1.4 multiplied 10 to 7 power 2, 2 multiplied 10 to 7 power meter per second, which corresponds to energies from 4 to 8.8 mega electron volts. According to the modern concepts, alpha particles are formed at the moment of radioactive decay when two protons and two neutrons move within the nucleus. Alpha decay occurs when a parent nucleus AZ with atomic mass number A and nuclear charge number Z spontaneously emits an alpha particle leaving a residual daughter nucleus alpha A minus 4 Z minus 2. Next reaction, formula number 2. Alpha decay usually occurs from the nuclear ground state, but decay from excited states may also occur. The alpha decay of a given parent nucleus often leads to daughter nuclei that are themselves alpha or beta radioactive, thus giving rise to a disintegration series. By 1935, the detailed decay schemes for three naturally occurring series that started with 238 uranium, Z equals 92, 235 uranium and 232 thorium, Z equals 90, had been discovered. The alpha particles observed for these naturally occurring decays have energies in the range of 5 to 10 mega electron volts and were used as the source of projectiles for nuclear reaction experiments until the use of particle accelerators took over in the 1940s years. The half lives of known alpha radioactive nuclei vary widely. Thus, the tungsten isotope 184 tungsten was a half-life of T sub 1 half greater than 8.3 multiplied 10 to 18 years, and the protactinium isotope 219 protactinium has T sub 1 half equals 5.3 multiplied 10 to minus 8 seconds. For even isotopes, the dependence of the half-life of the alpha decay energy Q sub alpha is described by the empirical Geiger-Natrell law. Formula number 3, where A and B are the constants that depend weakly on Z. Taking into account the charge of the nucleus Z, the relationship between the half-life T sub 1 half and the alpha decay energy can be represented as logarithm of T sub 1 half to the base 10 equals 1.6861 multiplied open bracket Z divided square root from Q sub alpha minus Z 2 divided 3 power close bracket multiplied a plus 28.9 formula number 4, where Z is the charge of the final nucleus. The half-life tears up 1/2 expressed in seconds, and the energy of alpha particle E sub alpha is expressed in megaelectron volts. Figure 1 shows experimental values of half-lives for alpha radioactive even isotopes. Z from 74 to 106, and their description using the relation 4. For odd, even odd, and odd nuclei, the general trend of logarithm of T sub 1/2 to the base 10 dependence on Q sub alpha remains, but the half-lives are 2 from 2 to 100 times longer than the for even nuclei with the same Z and Q sub alpha. Figure 1, dependence of the half-life of radioactive element of the kinetic energy of the alpha particle of a naturally radioactive element. Dashed line, the law of Geiger-Natel. Spontaneous alpha decay is allowed when the Q sub alpha value for the decay is positive. The energy of the emitted alpha particle is given by E sub alpha equals Q sub alpha multiplied m d divided m sub d plus m sub alpha, formula number 5, where m sub d and m sub alpha are the masses of the daughter nucleus and alpha particle, respectively, and the Q sub alpha is given in terms of binding energy B by Q sub alpha equals formula number 6, where B 2 equals 28.296 mega electron volts. The values obtained with the experimental binding energies are shown in figures 2 and 3. The alpha decay Q sub alpha value becomes positive above Z approximately equals 50, and generally for nuclei that are proton-rich compared to the most stable. An exceptional case is that the 8th beryllium, for which the Q sub alpha value is positive for the decay into 2 alpha particles. Figure number 2, figure number 3. Alpha decay is more important than other light element emissions because of the relatively large binding energy of the alpha particle together with its small Z value. The alpha decay of nuclear ground states completes with beta decay and fission decay. The alpha decay of nuclear excited states competes in addition with gamma decay. Man-made heavy elements are often most easily identified by the characteristic alpha decay series. For example, the element with Z equals 110, Darmstadtium, discovered in 1994 at GSI, Helmholtz Center for Heavy Iron Research, was identified from the detection of an alpha particles with an energy of 11.13 megaelectron volt and a half-life of about 400 microsecond in coincidence with the alpha particle from the decay of Z equals 100H daughter, whose properties had been studied in previous experiments. The wide range of the half-lives as well as the large values of these periods for many alpha radioactive nuclei is explained by the fact that the alpha particle cannot instantly leave the nucleus, despite the fact that this is energetically advantageous. In order to leave the nucleus, the alpha particle must overcome the potential barrier. The region at the nucleus boundary formed by the potential energy of electrostatic repulsion of the alpha particle and the final nucleus and the forces of attraction between the nucleus. From the point of view of classical physics, an alpha particle cannot overcome the potential barrier, since it does not have the necessary kinetic energy. However, quantum mechanics allows for this possibility. An alpha particle has a certain probability of passing through the potential barrier and leaving the nucleus. This quantum mechanical phenomenon is called the tunnel effect or tunneling. The higher the height and width of the barrier, the lower the probability of tunneling, and the half-life is correspondingly longer. The large range of half-lives of alpha emitters is explained by a different combination of the kinetic energies of alpha particles and the heights of the potential barriers. If the barrier did not exist, the alpha particle would leave the nucleus in a typical nuclear time of approximately equals 10 to minus 21 to 10 to minus 23 seconds. The basic theory for alpha decay was developed by George Gamow and others in 1930. One postulates of alpha particle moving in the potential well of an attractive strong interaction. The potential energy diagram for the 238th uranium decay is shown in figure 4. The radius of the strong interaction potential, R sub T, is determined by the distance between the centers when the surfaces of the alpha particle and the daughter nucleus touch. This is given approximately by R sub T equals R sub D plus R sub alpha, where R sub D equals 1.2 multiplied A to 1/3 Fermi is the radius the daughter nucleus, and R sub alpha equals 2.15 Fermi for the alpha particle. For illustrative purposes, the magnitude of the potential inside R sub T has been set to 0. The dashed line shows the Q sub alpha value energy of 4.27 mega electron volts. Beyond the distance R sub T, the interaction between the alpha particle and the daughter nucleus is determined by the repulsive Coulomb potential. V function from R equals 2 multiplied Z sub D multiplied E square divided R, where Z sub D is the nuclear charge number of the daughter nucleus. Figure number 4, the potential energy diagram for the alpha decay of 238th uranium. The solid line is the Coulomb barrier of the to the radius R sub T. The dashed line is the Q sub alpha value. The semi-classical picture developed by Gamow envisions an alpha particle moving back and forth classical inside the radius R sub T and hitting the potential barrier at R sub T with decay rate W sub C equals V divided 2 multiplied R sub T equals square root from Q multiplied Q sub alpha divided 2 multiplied mu multiplied R sub T square, where mu is the reduced mass, and we estimate the velocity V by Q sub alpha equals 1/2 multiplied mu multiplied V square. When the alpha particle hits the potential barrier, it has a probability P in the theory of quantum mechanics to tunnel through the barrier given by P equals formula number 7. The radius R sub C equals 2 multiplied Z sub D multiplied E square divided Q sub alpha, in which V sub V function of R equals Q sub alpha is referred to as a classical turning radius, since classically an alpha particle approaching the total nucleus from a large radius cannot go beyond that point. Integrations gives P equals formula number 8 where x equals square root from r sub t divided r sub c. The total alpha decay rate is w equals w sub c multiplied p, and the alpha decay half-life is given by t sub 1/2 equals natural logarithm of 2 divided w sub c multiplied p, formula number 9. The experimental half-lives for the alpha decays of 119 even nuclei with ground state angular moment of j equals 0 are compared to the gamma estimate in figures 5. One observes qualitative agreement with the gamma estimate over 25 orders of magnitude in the half-life, with a systematic trend for the experimental half-lives to be about from 10 to 100 times longer than predicted. This hindrance can be qualitatively interpreted as a probability that the actual many-body wave function of the parent nucleus has an overlap with the wave function representing the alpha particle plus daughter nucleus. Figure number 5, comparison of experimental and theoretical values of for logarithm of t sub 1/2 to the base 10. The structure dependence in this hindrance factor can be seen in figure 6, where the ratio of the experimental to theoretical decay rates are shown. One observes a reduction in the experimental rate as one approaches the magic number 126, and then a sudden jump up. From the form of equation 8, one obtains with some approximations the Geiger-Nuttall relation for alpha decay. Logarithm of t sub 1/2 to the base 10 approximately equals z sub d divided square root from q sub alpha. However, a more accurate empirical relation which is able to reproduce the alpha decay half-lives to within about a factor of 3 is logarithm of t sub 1/2 to the base 10 equals minus 51.37 plus 9.54 multiplied z sub d to 0.6 power divided square root from q sub alpha, formula number 10, where sub d is the charge of the daughter nucleus and q sub alpha is the units of the mega electron volt. General equation 10 has the same accuracy as equation 9, and Neisser equation contains the structure dependence observed in figure 6. Figure 6 ratios the experimental to theoretical alpha decay rates W, plotted as a function of neutron number. The top part of the figure shows the nuclei which are considered in the bottom part with the magic numbers z equals 82 and n equals 126 shown by the dashed lines. Equal 10 has been used to calculate the alpha decay half-life for those small nuclei in figure 2. The results for all nuclei are shown in figure 7. Results based on the HF1 model are shown in figure 8. One observes that alpha decay is responsible for the instability of nuclei above 208 plumbum, except for small region of nuclei around 232 thorium and 234 to 238 uranium. Figure number 7, figure number 8. The gamma model can be extended to the decay of non-zero spin nuclei, but adding a centrifugal barrier to the potential V sub v function of r corresponding to the relative angular momentum L between the daughter nucleus and the emitted nucleus. V sub L equals L multiplied open bracket L plus 1 closed bracket multiplied h bar square divided 2 multiplied mu multiplied r square. The model can be refined by considering a more realistic shape for the interior and surface region of the potential. A more quantitative understanding of alpha decay release of using many body wave functions for all three particles involved in the decay that incorporate the individual proton and neutron degrees of freedom. The experimental data, as well as the microscopic calculations, indicate deviations from the Gamow model that are related to change in shape and change in shell structure between nuclei. The basic idea behind the Gamow model can also be used to calculate lifetimes for proton and cluster decay. The Q value systematics is the essential ingredient which determines the existence and half-lives of this charged particle decay. For example, it is shown in figures 9 and 10, the Q values for 14th carbonium decay. The large peak in the Q values just above 208 plumbum is what determines the region of the nuclei which have been observed to have a 14th carbonium decay branch. Also, even in the most likely case, cluster emission is extremely small, approximately equals 10 to minus 12 or less, compared to alpha decay. Figure number 9 and figure number 8, number 10, experimental values of 14th carbonium decay U values. Next slide, applied literature. Next slide, questions for students. First, formulate the displacement rule for alpha decay. Second question, how to determine the range of the path in the air of any particle in radioactive decay? 3. Prerequisite to the theory of tunneling. Question number 4. What does the fine structure of the alpha spectrum mean? 5. Short-lived isotopes emit particles that are more likely to pass the potential barrier. Explain. Thank you for your attention.